This is the Congo in Africa. It's a vast wilderness and the least explored of all jungles. From up here, the forest looks similar to the ones that grow in the Amazon or Southeast Asia. But down below, there are some unexpected sights. Crisscrossing this forest are countless miles of highways, and they were made by something big. Forest elephants roam great distances in their search for food, but to survive, they must emerge from the gloom of the forest. And clearings like this one are a magnet for elephants from far and wide. These elephants live in much smaller groups than their savanna cousins. This might be the first time that one group will have seen another for a month. For the adult males, it's a welcome break in an otherwise largely solitary existence. They're not the only animals attracted to the clearing. Forest buffaloes and Red River hogs are also regular visitors, as are bongos, which are very difficult to see outside these clearings. All these large forest animals have come here to collect an essential element of their diet that lies buried beneath the mud. And the elephant's trunk is the perfect tool for reaching it. To get what they seek, the prospecting elephants must first blow away the covering layer of silt. Satisfaction at last. They're collecting a particular kind of clay that contains vital minerals scarce in their natural diet. It may be mud, but there's just nothing quite like it for enriching the blood. The clay also helps to absorb the toxins found in many leaves that the elephants eat. There are other benefits to coming here. These clearings are the only places where the forest elephants can get together in such numbers. When they return to the forest, they will have to go their separate ways once more. If large animals are rare in jungles, then groups of large animals actually living together are even rarer. Further south, other, bigger predators prowl the tundra. Wolves. For them, finding food on the plains is an even greater challenge. Not only is their prey seasonal, it's also hard to find. They've been searching for days without a sign. Somewhere in this immense landscape, there is food for them. This is it, caribou. Traveling 30 miles a day, they can cover nearly 2,000 miles during the summer months. The wolves will starve if they don't find the caribou, but it's no easy task to locate prey that never stops traveling. Biting flies and the quest for new pasture drives the migration ever onwards. Wolf has finally picked up the trail. The caribou are close. At last, a chance. The hunt is on. The wolf panics the herd, and the weak and young are singled out. A calf is separated from its mother. At the goose colony, it's high summer and eggs are hatching. The young all emerge within a day or two, a marvel of timing. The colony is now home to 1 million goslings.